Of thee, and kings shall come out of thee, and I shall establish a covenant between me and thee, and thou seed after thee, and the generations an everlasting covenant to be God unto God, and to be the seed after thee. I want you to understand, people of God, that Isaac is the one that God is going to use to bring this promise to pass. So it is after 20 years, Abraham is enjoying, Uncle Bess, the father-the-son relationship between him and his son. It is a father-son relationship, and he's taken for advantage. This is my boy. I'm training him up. I'm teaching him. I want him to be just like me. He want him to act like me. I want him to know like me. I want him to do like I do. Now, Abraham has witnessed, amen, Isaac's bar mitzvah. His witness, Abraham, is poured into Isaac, and he is, and not only has he poured into Isaac, but Isaac is also, amen, Abraham is feeling that Isaac is going to carry his legacy. He's looking at this man to further carry what he needs to see. It's good to know that when you can close your eyes, that you can depend on somebody to carry, amen, what you have put into them and not let it die. Can I get any help in here? Even when it comes to your children, and this is, I try hard, and being of my age now that my mother is getting older and my father's getting older, I try to do as much as I can for them because they have raised me. So every now and then I have to take her out for just a day, me and my mom a day, just to enjoy each other. And my dad, you know, he likes to eat, so you know, you take him to a buffet, he's happy all week. Amen. It don't take that much to please him, praise God. But you got to do certain things because, amen, you don't know how long you'll have your parents. I don't know about anybody. There are some people that wish the mothers and the fathers fathers were still here, and they're not here. They wish they could say, my mama's here, my father's here, and we spent the day together. It was just a good time. So this is why Isaac, amen, and Abraham are spending that father-son relationship, because Abraham is starting to see Isaac as his future. Are you with me here? He starts to see Isaac, amen, as a priority. Amen. In fact, Abraham starts to see Isaac, amen, as a benefit of the benefit of what God was doing for him for his faithfulness unto God. Are you still with me here? Just when Isaac is about to transitioning from being just a promised child into the fulfillment of the promise, amen, the Bible here in chapter number 22 states that God speaks to Abraham again. Much he speaks to him again. He spoke to him before, but now he's speaking again. Well, I need to take a quarter there and let you know that God is still a speaking God. And what we're trying to do, we're trying to hold on old words that God spoke 25 years ago, or amen, 30 years ago, that's fine. But amen, God is still speaking God, and he's speaking now for this now generation. And we need to catch up to the time. Can I get any help in here? So now the Bible is very clear. And it says that Abraham, he speaks to Abraham again. But when he speaks to Abraham again, he's not speaking about a covenant again. He's not speaking about a blessing again.
Yeah.
He's not speaking about a promise again. Even in this time, he's not even talking about his legacy, Elder Beecham. He's not talking about his prosperity. He's not talking about enlarging territory. Amen. Not this time.
Yeah.
But this time, he makes a different request. This time in his request, he says, then take thy son Abraham. Listen what it says, thy only son, Abraham, take thy only son Isaac, amen, and sacrifice him. Did you hear what he said? Wait a minute, you said only son.
Mm-hmm.
But you have another son by the name of Ishmael. Are you with me here? You have another son by the name of Ishmael. So, amen, Isaac is not your only son. Ishmael, amen, you have another son by the name of Ishmael. But Ishmael was not the son of the promise. Ishmael was the son that he got by the handmaid. But Isaac was the son that he promises. And I want you to understand that God only recognizes, Lord, y'all ain't gonna say nothing here. He only recognizes, amen, things that are not of the flesh. Amen. Things that are of the flesh, he does not recognize. So when you start to sing in the flesh, he doesn't recognize you. When you start to preach in the flesh, he doesn't recognize you. When you start to operate in the flesh, he does not recognize you. He does not recognize things that are done in the flesh, but he recognizes things that are done in the spirit. And Isaac is, amen, the promise to you, what was promised to him. The only reason why he recognizes him and he's done, amen, he recognizes him is because he was given or even prophesied that he was going to give you a son. Come on here. And because he recognizes he's not flesh, come on, he recognizes this had to be done in the spirit, and because God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So thank you, Ishmael, but no disrespect, but you are not the promise, but Isaac is the promise. Come on, and God is going to recognize your promise. I want you to clap your hands and realize that if God ever promised you something, he's got to keep what he promised. And I want you to understand, I don't care what it looked like or what it seemed like, God's going to be a man that's going to keep to his promise. Why don't y'all open your mouth and shout hallelujah in here? And what we need to understand, that God says, I'll always give you the blessing because, amen, before I give you, excuse me, I'll always give you the test before I give you the lesson. He said, I'll give it to you. I'll let you go through it. He said, I'm always going to make you rich. He said, but you got to learn how to be poor first. He said, I will always let you go through things so that you can learn. because you're not talking to me. You're not saying nothing to me. I am one person on the mess, amen, that I can go to God for people, and God will speak to me. And when he speaks to me for people, but when I go through my own things, it seems like I can't hear anything. Maybe I'm the only one. When I want to pray for me, it seems like my prayers ain't going nowhere. And when I'm trying to get me a breakthrough, it seems like my breakthrough can't come for me. But it seems like for everybody else, I can get one for them. He said, I said, well, why are you quiet? Why are you not saying nothing when I'm going through? He said, Ivory Jenkins, let me tell you something. What are you doing? He said, since when does the teacher talk?
We've been well, but when we look like the coast is clear,